One of my tunings that's quite similar to a standard harp, but really improves one of its main problem areas, is power draw. Now, power draw is exactly the same as a normal harp in holes 1 to 6. So all your normal licks will work in that really important area there. But on a normal harp, as you know, at hole number 7, the breathing pattern changes. And that top octave can be very challenging. And you can't bend the draw notes. It's kind of a problem area. So in order to address that problem, I change the tuning of the top octave so that all the draw notes bend in the top octave. So it's really nice and bluesy up there. And all the bends are the same as you get down on the bottom end of the harp. So let me demonstrate. Here's number 4 draw. And now you can get the same thing on number 8 draw. And number 3 draw. You can get that on number 7 draw. You can bend that one now. And also 2 draw. That's the same as 9 draw. So you can hear that basically I'm getting a lot of the same bends in the top octave now, draw bends, as I have in the rest of the harp. So it's very expressive and soulful. But there's not a big learning curve because all your main holes number 1 to 6 are exactly the same. So that's power draw. Now, my personal favorite to get yourself into a zone of pure musical bliss is power bender tuning. As with power draw tuning, we have these in 2 versions made by 2 top Chinese harmonica manufacturing companies. The East Top version is a traditional sandwich construction, and the Kongsheng version is a lip comb version. So I'll use the Kongsheng just for this demo. Now, Power Bender is played by a couple of top Asian players. There's Long Deng Jie from China. He's a Hona endorser, but he gets many of his diatonic harps tuned to Power Bender tuning. If you listen to many of his videos with a lot of high-end draw bends, it's pretty well guaranteed they're in power bender tuning because he loves it so much. Another fantastic player who I really like a lot is from South Korea, Byung-ho Kwon. And if you've listened to K-pop music and there's harmonica on there, it's likely to be him playing because he's a top session player in South Korea. And he loves power bender as well. That's his main tuning. So it's already being used by these 2 great Asian players. Now, the reason power bender is just so sexy and expressive is that every draw note can be bent from hole number 1 to hole number 10. Now, not only does this make it really expressive in every single hole with easy draw bends, but it also gives you really nice chromatic ability, especially in the middle octave, where on a standard Richter harp you have to use overblows. Now you can get all those overblows in the middle octave as draw bends. So hole number 4 overblow is just a draw bend now. Hole number 5 overblow is a draw bend. Just a draw bend, and hole number 6 overblow is also a draw bend. So this means you can play nice chromatic runs. And all your main home notes and cross harp are draw note. So you can really get wailing on those home notes in every octave. If you're into overblowing, Power Bender, because it has an even breathing pattern, allows you to overblow every single hole, including hole number 10, number 9, and all the other holes down below. So it can be played fully chromatically quite easily. Even without overblowing, it's quite easy to get more jazzy sort of key modulation out of Power Bender, like, say, with the tune Sweet Georgia Brown. Thank you. so easy to play on Powerbender compared to standard Richter tuning. Okay, well, I hope this little video has made you more aware of the easy availability of my favorite tunings, Power Draw and Power Bender. So I hope you'll give at least one of them a try. Bye for now.